We will start the next topic, that is structure. Structure is a common term in any programming language. So let's check what a structure is. It is a convenient tool for handling a group of logically related data items. They help us to organize the complex data in a more meaningful way, and it is a concept that is often need to be used in program design. So I think example can make it more clear. If we want to save the details of a student or details of an employee or details of a particular book, if we are writing a software for a library, then corresponding to that student, we have certain details needed. Corresponding to a student, maybe we need a roll number, we need marks, we need name of that student. Or if there are three main subjects like physics, chemistry, maths, then marks of physics, marks of chemistry, marks of maths, and then the total marks or percentage like that. So there are a set of values corresponding to a particular student. So that all those details can be clubbed together. So that concept is called structure. So it is a collection of logically related data, and they can be of same data type or different data type. In case of an array, if we need to save the marks of 30 students, what we do? We write array marks of 30. That means same marks is of same data type. For example, float marks 30. That means all the marks is of float type. So only same data types can be combined in an array. But in case of structure, if we save the details of a student, it includes different data types. For name, we need a string character array. For roll number, we need an integer or a long integer. For marks, we know that it cannot be integer alone, so you should give it as float. So like that. So examples are given. If we need a time in a program, time consists of three parts: seconds, minutes, and hours. So you can include it as a structure. So structure time will have three elements. One is seconds, second is minutes, and the third one is hours. Just like that, if we make a date as a structure, it has three structure components or structure elements, that is day, month, and year. Like that. Book, city, address, etc. So now back to the first definition. It is a convenient tool for handling a group of logically related data items, and items are of same data type or different data type. This is the syntax for defining a structure. Here struct is a keyword, and struct after space, what you give the tag name, that is the name of that structure. Then within that curly brackets, you can give the different structure elements or structure members. So data type, space, the corresponding member name. Okay, you can give the sufficient number of structure elements and then enclose it in curly brackets and then terminate it with a semicolon. So this is the syntax for structure definition. This is an example for this is a case of a book. So struct, that is a keyword, and here I give the name of the structure as book bank. Okay, book underscore bank, and here the structure name is book underscore bank, and it has how many elements? It has four elements. One is the title of the book, so it is a character array or string. So we give data type char space title, and 20 elements we can give it according to programmers or users choice. Then author name, again char author 15. Then number of pages is integer, cannot be float. So number of pages is the data type is int. Then price need not be an integer, so float price. So the four major data corresponding to a book, that is one is title of the book, then author of the book, then number of pages and price of that book. These four datas are combined in a structure, and the structure name is book bank, and the four elements, the four structure elements are title, author, pages, and price. So this was the syntax for defining a structure, and this example will make it more clear. Next is, so you can see this also, we define the four structure elements, so it will be like this. Okay. Oh, they are of different data types. Now, what is the difference between array and structure? First, I already discussed array is a collection of related data elements of same data type, whereas structure can have elements of same as well as different data types. And array is a derived data type, whereas structure is a programmer defined data type, because array is already specified, character array, integer array, float array, like that. It's a derived data type. It's not defined by the programmer, whereas structure is defined by the programmer. The same thing is explained in a slightly different way. Any array behaves like a built-in data type. All we have to do is declare an array variable, because you need not define about integer array or float array. You just have to declare it. But in case of structure, first we have to design and declare a data structure before the variables of that type are declared. So in the last case, we only define the structure. We have not declared the variables for a structure. So it has to be done separately. Declaring structure variables. After declaring a structure format, we can declare the variables of that type. So earlier in book bank, what we did was we defined that structure, and that structure name is book bank, but we have not declared variables for it. Okay, that can be done similar to declaration of variables of any other data types. It includes the following elements: the keyword struct, then structure tag name, that is a structure name. Then list of variables name, variable name separated by commas, then a terminating semicolon. So this is an example. Earlier we have defined a structure named book bank, and we need three variables for storing the data or the details of three books, say book 1, book 2 and book 3. They are the variable names. So struct space book bank, that is the name of that structure, then space book 1 comma book 2 comma book 3. Here book 1, book 2 and book 3 are the variables of which type of structure? Book bank. Now we should remember that the members of a structure are not variables. So here the members of structure and variables of structure are different. Members of structure book bank is, there are four members. One is title, another is author name, then next is number of pages, one variable for number of pages and another variable for price. So they are the structure members. They are not variables. Here we define three variables, say book 1, book 2 and book 3. So corresponding to each variable, these members will have values. For example, book 1 has corresponding author name, corresponding title name, corresponding pages, corresponding price. Similar way, book 2 also has the corresponding four values, like that. When the compiler comes across a declaration statement, it reserves memory space for the structure variables. So only when structure variables are declared, then only the memory will be allocated by the compiler for the particular structure variables. So I'll explain the third point again. Third point says that while we declare an array variable, we can directly use it, because there is no definition of array part, because integer array, float array, it's already defined. So there is no need for defining an array. We can directly go for declaring the array variable. For example, if we need, say, to save 30 marks, we directly give int marks 30 or float marks 30 based on the data type. But in case of structure, first, we have to design and declare a data structure before the variables of that type are declared. So, when we compare array and structure, in array, we just have to declare the variables. But in case of structure, first we have to define the structure by specifying the various structure members or elements. And in second part, we declare the structure variables. So, I hope now the difference between arrays and structures are more clear. So back to declaring the structure variables. This is one common method: struct keyword followed by structure name, then the three variable names. So this is one method of declaring structure variables. Another option is we are allowed to combine both the structure definition and variable declaration together in one statement. If that be the case, along with the definition, we know that after definition it is terminated with a semicolon. So in between this closing bracket and semicolon, you can give the variable names like this. So there are two ways of declaring structure variables. This method is combining structure definition and declaring structure variables. In that case, just before the terminating semicolon, you can give the structure variables. Second option is you can define it separately and enclose it with the in brackets, curly brackets, and terminate it with semicolon. And after that, as a separate statement, you can give struct space, structure name space, variable names, terminated with the semicolon. So both these methods are allowed for declaring structure variables.